lovely Callimaries, this is Callimara here. Today, we are going to be doing something a little bit different. As you guys might already know, I actually got the amazing opportunity of being chosen as creator on the rise in Australia last week, and it brought in so many new viewers to my channel. We're actually at 17k now, so if you're new here, hi! And because my channel is growing at such an ungodly rate, I wanted to step back from drama commentary and do more creative stuff, which is something I personally find more fulfilling and you guys seem to enjoy more anyway. That's all to say that instead of just talking about frustration-inducing or faith in humanity-losing topics, I'd rather spread a bit of humor and positivity in your days instead. So, I've decided to start a new series where I draw my favorite YouTubers and talk about fond memories I had watching them, why I love them, and how great they are. Basically, this series is an excuse for me to make fan art for people whose content I really enjoy and show my support for them and the stuff they do. And I think there's no one who really needs that show of support right now more than Thumin. If you don't know who Thumin is, she is an artist on YouTube with over 160,000 subscribers. She's been experiencing a ton of racism and harassment since October last year, all because she drew herself as Kiki from the Studio Ghibli film Kiki's Delivery Service. If you guys want to hear more about this situation, I suggest watching the video that Thumin herself has made, which I will be linking in the description below, along with her Twitter, which you guys should definitely follow because she is such an incredible artist. I know that race swapping is something of a touchy subject in the art community, but this isn't even a case of that. Like, this is literally just someone imagining themselves in a world that they loved so much, and the fact that people are harassing her for it just because she happens to have a darker complexion than the original character is genuinely heartbreaking. And obviously, I'm not the only person who feels this way, because people have made lots of videos on this, and a lot of people have also been really kind and drew lots of amazing fan art of Thumin on Twitter, so I decided I would too. So, Thumin is an art commentary channel, and I think she has an amazing art style. It gives me tons of old-school anime vibes like Sailor Moon, the classic one, not the remade one, and Ranma Half, if you guys know that show. But I think what strikes me the most about her drawings is just how dreamy and tranquil her characters look. It's just the way she draws their facial expressions that makes me as a viewer feel really relaxed and at ease. She's really good at drawing half-lidded eyes in a way that makes her characters look so peaceful, and so I try to emulate it as best as I can in my style, and I don't know if it translated as well. But I tried my best, and I think it looks pretty okay. What really completes the look for me, though, are the eyebrows. I think that eyebrows tend to get overlooked a lot when it's actually one of the easiest way to show a character's emotion. By exaggerating it and contorting it into different angles, shapes, and even just how low or high you decide to place them on the forehead, you can immediately show off a character's personality or emotion. The way Thumin utilizes eyebrows on her drawings is by putting them quite high up from the eyes, which usually communicates that the character is more approachable and open, and then flat in shape, which is an eyebrow shape I personally really love because it gives the characters a more innocent and softer look. And fun fact, that's actually how I prefer to shape my eyebrows in real life. As for the clothes, Thumin mostly has her persona in a really cute pink turtleneck, so I definitely wanted to keep that element in when drawing her character, and basically I came up with like a pretty out there design by making the turtleneck a crop top paired with like a plaid skirt and fishnets. So I started doing that for a little bit, but then I hesitated because I realized that I don't really know how old Thumin is or what her fashion preferences are, and the last thing I want is to accidentally sexualize a minor, so I decided to play it safe and just turn her turtleneck into a comfy dress and added a little belt to get I can't speak, a little belt to give it some flair. I feel like I learn a lot from redrawing other artists' work because it always ends up helping me improve my own drawings in the end. This even goes for Lily Jean's work because, and as I say that, she actually just strikes my video again, which is fun. It's super... It's okay. Yes, even though I'm not picking anything up from their techniques or skills, it's just a really good opportunity anyway for me to reflect on my own style and habits. And I feel like it helps me break out of the subconscious rules and conventions I've set up for myself. For instance, while lining this piece, which I didn't record because it gets pretty samey and takes up a long time, I realized that maybe the reason I struggle so much drawing line art is because when I first got Clip Studio Paint, I didn't really like the stabilization because it caused a lot of lag, and I'm an impatient little gremlin, so I usually kept it at zero. Yes, that's right, all this time, my works were all drawn with zero pen stabilization. And because I had no stabilization, the only way I could get a clean line is by drawing them really, really fast. And fun fact about drawing lines really fast, you don't get much control over the thickness of it. You're just throwing it out there and hoping for the best. But after watching other YouTubers and people on TikTok do their lines at an actual reasonable pace, I decided to be a bit spicy and do the same. So I finally cranked the stabilization up instead of being a little brat and deciding not to use it at all and just draw slower. And it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it a lot. Anyway, another probably more relevant example, although Thumin was definitely one of those YouTubers that inspired me to actually do my lines right because I watched a ton of her videos while making this one. Another relevant example was when I started filling in the base colors for this drawing. I was actually really surprised to find that Thumin used a bright fuchsia pink as the undertone for the skin and indigo for the hair because I would have never thought to use those colors when I color in my characters. I've always felt that I was a bit lacking in that regard because my color choices are always, like, they're pretty samey, pretty limited and basic. It's just the usual, oh, skin has to be this beigey color between orange and yellow, and it's just a variation of the brightness from there, and black hair should be a gray base with black shading, and it's sad. I've only recently started to be a bit more adventurous with my colors, and I'm really glad I got to do this piece because it really broke me out of my rut. Thumin also made a video on coloring dark skin, which I highly recommend you guys watching if you're struggling the same way I do. As someone who loves makeup, you know that eyebrows are arguably one of the most important parts of a makeup look and usually takes the longest amount of time to do. I like it when eyebrows have this nice gradient to them. I think it makes them look a bit softer and less harsh overall, and I think it helped the expression in this character look a bit dreamy as well. I had a bit of trouble figuring out the right eye color for the character because my eyes, for some reason, can't decide whether she had pink or purple eyes. It's an optical illusion. But I went with pink because that was the most dominant color I could see and what my color picker tool told me. I did end up adjusting the shade a few times to make sure it looked close enough though. Overall, I really love Thumin's color schemes the most out of her art. I always love it when artists start having signature colors or tones, and for Thumin, she uses this amazing rich lapis lazuli color that gives an almost lo-fi aesthetic to her drawings that I absolutely adore. I'm purely going off of her thumbnails and her speed draws and some of the works of hers that I've seen on Twitter, but I think that's probably why I felt her drawings made me feel really cozy. I always listen to lo-fi when I'm chilling and drawing, and it always induces good vibes, and no joke, Thumin's art deserves to be on the album cover of a lo-fi playlist. Or at the very least, the background of a lo-fi mix on a YouTube video. Her art just deserves more recognition, okay? And also, while I'm shading in her skin, I just want to clarify that I'm not trying to make her skin look lighter or whitewash the character in any way. I'm simply adding light to give the drawing a bit more depth. That's always been an issue I had when shading. Back when I was just starting out, I would always accidentally make my character's face too muggy with the shadows, so much so that you could barely even see their nose or mouth. And I found that adding a bit of glow under the shading, even before you add blush or soft shading for depth, really helps those features withstand the shadows a bit better, just because there's a greater contrast between the light and dark. I really love how Thumin has such good coherence on her thumbnails. She uses colors that belong to the same palette and go harmoniously with each other, and also, she has a very solid art style, which I think is amazing. That's really something I want to try and achieve for my own channel and my art in general. At the moment, it's just kind of Yandere Simulator Pink, which I'm not a big fan of because it makes me think of Yandere Dev. My life is a dilemma. But yes, that is all to say that Thumin is an amazing artist who definitely deserves more credit and attention than what she has now. And guys, just this harassment is absolutely insane to me. It makes absolutely no sense. And I implore you guys to show your support for her. If you're an artist, please go and make her some fan art. I think fan art should be the way we communicate love to people, because it's such an effort to illustrate something for free just to tell someone that, hey, I think you're pretty great. And with that, I am going to end this video here. Thank you guys so much for watching all the way to the end. If you're a Callimari, you might already know that literally as I was writing the script, I got hit with another DMCA from Lily Jean. This time she created a new account to strike my channel with, because even YouTube stopped listening to her insane claims. So my recreating Lily Jean's art video is down again. I've submitted another counter to get the video back and lift my strike, but I'm not going to make another video on this just because it really isn't worth it, and she doesn't deserve a whole video dedicated to herself. But yeah, if you guys want to support me, I've got a Ko-fi account, subscribe to become an official Callimari, sticker coming soon, follow me on all my social media, check out my comic, because that would make me really happy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye!